First person getting a toast this evening will be John. So John, if you'll make your way.
You gotta flip the button up.
I gotta push the button up.
Yeah! There it is.
Yeah.
Great start.
How's everybody tonight?
Good? Yeah, John!
This speech would be a lot better if it's heard hard over the bar. Okay, so I want to start the speech off by saying my favorite joke from me and Clay's favorite show. So, why do women wear makeup and perfume?
Why, John?
Why, John?
Because they're ugly and they stink. Now you guys know why I'm not getting married. Clay is married. So, I know it's traditional for the best man to talk about the various girlfriends the groom has had. And out of respect, I see Jocelyn, you know, shaking her head, out of respect for Jocelyn, I'm not gonna do that. But needless to say, I think number 43 was the magic number. 43, number 43! just kidding, right? That's a joke. That's a joke. Okay. Okay, so I coached Clay since I was 16 years old. I was a junior in high school. And I'd just like to take us back in kind of a memory trail here. So, Clay, do you remember the time that we threw a party at your house when your parents were out of town? And we broke that little chandelier thing that was falling off of your living room fan? And we blamed it on Galen. I don't even think Galen was there, to be honest. Do you remember the time in college when Cameron passed out early? And me and you went in our rooms, we wiped our bare butts all over the sink. Do you remember the time when you had a little bit too much whiskey to drink and you thought that truck was talking trash to you? Clay Pellet tried to find a truck. An inanimate object.
Did he win?
I don't know. No. No, he did not win. Do you remember the time that we were outside Aspen Heights, me, you, Will, Cameron? Galen and Will, sorry. And we were like messing around, we were wrestling, and we were fake beating up on Will, and that cop pulled up, and he was like, what is going on here? And like trying to arrest us and stuff. You remember that time? That was very interesting. Okay, so I'm not very good at the mushy part, but I guess I'll be able to. We all know Clay. Clay is the type of guy who can get along with anybody. He is friends with every single person he meets. You can be the worst person in the world, and Clay will love you. That kid.
What are you saying about me?
Jocelyn, you're great. I love you. That kid loves everybody, and he's also loyal. He will. Clay, it doesn't matter what it is, he has your back. We all know these things about Clay. So what I want to talk about right now is how Clay had an impact on my life. And how I see that through Jocelyn, I guess is what I'm trying to say. When me and Clay became friends, we were 16 years old. You know, I was kind of a shy guy, you know, I didn't really talk to girls or whatever. I was kind of a loser, to be honest. I mean, not a loser.
You still are!
I was not a loser. cool guy. Clay used to make fun of me in eighth grade, how he would come up to me in the hallway. He'd be like, hey, John, what's up? And I'd be like, I talked to him. I was a weird guy. Drew Coy, Clay is such a confident guy. He's so confident in himself and his friends that you can't help but be more confident in yourself because of it. Clay makes you seriously the best person you could possibly be. And everybody who's friends, I see a lot of my friends from Baylor and Waxahachie out here, they can definitely agree with this. Clay is the type of person who makes you the absolute best and most confident person in yourself you can possibly be. And great for Jocelyn. I see the same thing animating through her. I see a group, a couple that will go through and tackle all the obstacles in life that anything that's thrown at them, you know, Clay, I don't know about Jocelyn, but Clay has no fear. Seriously, no fear. And it doesn't matter what it is. That kid is there for me. And that's what I love about Clay. Clay, I had some hard times going through high school and college, but it didn't matter what it was. Clay always saw the bright side of things. He always told me, you know, John, you just sat. We were over there right now. Seriously. And I was like, so nervous about this speech. And I was like, well, what am I going to do? He's like, you're John Hussein. You're going to go up there. You're going to crush it. And I hope I crushed it. So here we're playing Jocelyn. I don't know how we'll top that, but I'm sure we will. All right, next up, we have Alex and Savannah.
Alex and
Savannah.
I'm Sarah. Okay, hi everyone. Welcome to the wedding. I'm Jocelyn's sister, her favorite sister. I'm Alex, and I just want you to short and sweet. I was going to say, welcome to the wedding. And I love you guys, and congratulations. So, that's pretty much it.
Hello, I am Savannah. I'm Jocelyn's favorite sister. Actual favorite sister. I am the maid of honor that was never actually said maid of honor, but it's obvious. I mean, I have red hair. Who doesn't love red hair? So I just want to say that I'm so glad that you two found each other. Y'all are perfect. I love Clay, and Clay obviously loves me. I'm sorry, I was already taken. I'm sorry. It's okay though. Y'all are perfect. I love y'all. I'm so glad I got to be a part of this. All right.
I just wanted to say that, you taught me everything I know, like Spanish, you know, and you gave me your Spanish-English dictionary, the most meaningful gift. Our names were right next to each other. We speak the language. I just want to say, te quiero mucho, which means I love you very much.
Okay. We were in Spanish together. We sat right by each other. We were in every class together since fifth grade. You are my soul sister, my true best friend. I love you. I hate that I'm living far away from you. But anyways, I have something to say. Most of the things, Padre.
And that concludes the speeches for the night, so thank y'all for coming. And, you know, regardless of Spanish, English, whatever, you and I speak the same language. All I have to do is just give you one look. Just one look.
And Justin, but we also speak this language, you know, like when I say... And just one more thing. And I
will always love you.
I'm
clearly people have been watching inappropriate movies. Next, we have the incomparable, wonderful Lauren Pasalakis. I don't know your last name.
Yeah, like the dog?
But... You said Pavlov, I said like the dog.
No, Pavlov's sneeze.
You ever feel like Pavlov's cat?
No.
I got
that. Okay, so they didn't tell me that I would be following all the funny acts tonight. I thought I was going first. So mine is a little bit more serious. But I had a nightmare last night that I forgot what I was going to say. So I woke up at 3 a.m. and wrote it down. So I'm just going to have to read off my phone so I don't forget anything. And so I'm crying. Okay, so for those of you that don't know me, my name is Lauren, and I was Jocelyn's roommate for 3 years at TDU. I'm very happy to be here tonight to celebrate the wedding of my dear friend Jocelyn to her new husband, Clay. Jocelyn, you look absolutely stunning tonight. Clay is one lucky man. When Jocelyn and I met, I never thought I would be standing next to her on her wedding day. We went potluck in the dorms our freshman year and didn't know each other at all when first we did this day. Let's just say that she called her parents and told them she wanted to transfer after 2 weeks of living with me. I fired over the fact that I thought Jocelyn was some weird emo girl, and she went over the fact that I was stuck up. The fact that she thought I was stuck up. We became inseparable. From doing cheerleading moves outside of our apartment to talking to our shrimp, I've never had a friendship quite like ours. Most people don't get our humor, but that just makes our jokes so much better. I thank God every day for placing such a smart, beautiful, caring best friend in my life, and I love you so much. Clay, I'm jealous that you're taking my place and that you're the one that gets to come home to Jocelyn every day. I'm so glad that even though you got turned down, oh, I don't know, maybe 15 plus more times, that you never gave up on Jocelyn. We may have thought it was weird at the time, and we may still give you a hard time about it, but it just shows how much you care about Jocelyn. I couldn't imagine a more perfect man for her. You are so sweet and loving towards Jocelyn, and I truly admire our relationship. Now please raise your glasses to Jocelyn and Clay. May the happiness you have tonight only be the start of a wonderful life ahead. I love you both.
I love
you.
And now we have the best speaker in the family. Sandy's gonna come up and do a toast.
Thank you very much. And John, I'd just like to say thank you so much for the inner workings of the Wolf Pack. All you guys need is a small Asian man and a baby, and you're all set. Thank you so much, everyone, for being here tonight. I'm Sandy Thornton, the mother of the bride. And first off, I just want to start with something really important. I hope everyone likes my pantsuit. Because having a big family is a blessing in that you get a lot of feedback. And everybody knows that feedback is a blessing. I tried it on, my daughter Alex said that I look like the last scene of Mamma Mia when the old ladies are dancing. Which was great because that was exactly what I was going for. And I'll be performing to a Queen song when the dance portion is even starts. There were also several Hillary Clinton references that were made. So I stand before you tonight riddled with self-confidence and pride. Tonight I would like to say my vows to the brilliant, beautiful couple. Jocelyn and Clay. I vow to be reasonable and rational during the holidays. I'm going to share you with Bill and Leanne Kelly. I lose my mind every December. All year I'm rational, and at Christmas time, it's my Achilles heel, but I vow to reel myself in. I vow to visit you without rearranging furniture, cleaning and or pursing my lips, and gazing around the room with a critical gaze. My kids know what I'm upset because that's what I do on personal holidays. It's physically keeping in what I want to say, but I can't say it. I vow to love and support you both equally. I'm going to spend the same amount of money on your birthday presents and your Christmas presents. I vow to think before I speak, and I'm going to remember that you two are your own family now. That you have your own values, you have your own traditions, you have your own priorities. Now, obviously, you're not going to be as good or as effective or as smart as any of us have been, but I've already messed all this up. Never mind, forget everything I said. I'm just going to vow to love you both. Congratulations. To Dawson and Coach. I'm also announcing the father-daughter dance at this time.
Now we have the mother-son, Clay, and Leanne. Here they come. Thank you. There's also a